happening, we are mass producing unemployed degree holders instead of mass producing influencers. That's what we should be doing. That's the easiest way for them to make more money. Kids or South Africans in high school need to aspire to be Uncle Waffles. They need to aspire to be more like Michali, more like K-Yams. As South Africans, we need to push like kids to become go more into like the influencer environment or social media marketing environment. Why do I say this? I say this because in South Africa, we suffer from dependency on the government. We suffer from poverty, we suffer from unemployment, we suffer from all these things that if we just encourage kids from a learning age already, from like schooling age, from the ages of, what's grade 8? 14, I think, from the ages of 14 to like 18, I feel like we should be encouraging South African kids to be pursuing, or you know, to move away from the whole mentality of just going to varsity. Like, I just want to go to varsity, I just want to become a lawyer, just want to become a doctor, whatever, accountant, all of that. I think we need to move away from that and like explore the mass production of influencers. Like, I feel like South Africa needs to be producing more influencers, you know. We need to try to also like insert ourselves in the international platforms and where, you know, Americans are watching influencers. I feel like that's what as South Africans we need to be pushing for. That's what the Department of Education should be pushing for. That's what our economy should be pushing for now. I'm not saying this is a long-term thing, but I just feel like for now we should be trying to encourage kids to be more into social media, like provide equipment for them to pursue these things, because I know there's a lot. I know I can't say, oh, we need to all be influencers and things like that when 50% of South Africans don't have phones. Do you know what I mean? So I get that, and that's why I feel like in high school or school environment already, we need to be providing kids with like equipment, encourage them to, you know, go into social media, become influencers, build their personal brand, and try to make money from there instead of, you know, pursuing debt by going to varsity. When I say we need to encourage South Africans or South African kids to become influencers, what I mean is we need to encourage them to move more into like personal branding from the beginning, from when they are kids already. That's what I feel like should be happening. And by that I mean, you know, creating communities around their interests, you know, around what they're interested in, like gaming, photography, whatever interests them, you know, doesn't matter. Whatever interests them, I feel like we should be encouraging them to pursue that on a social media platform. Finding their niche, finding what they feel, you know, their community, finding people that resonates with them. So when I say we need to encourage them to become influencers, what I mean is we need to encourage them to create a personal brand, create a community from a niche that they are very interested in, whether it's gaming, whether it's socks, you know, anything, whether it's photography, whether it's talking about grass. For example, if they create like a brand around socks, you know, a lot of people like socks, you know, there's a community for people that like socks, right? They like the design, how, you know, you design socks, how you, whatever, you know, the quality, you know, things like that. You can create a community around that, and by doing that, you're also opening South Africa or opening that person up to like international people that like socks. Because by creating that community is not only going to be based off, you know, South Africans, it can be based off international interests. And by, you know, creating a brand that is international means that, you know, international brands might, socks, for example, with the socks, international socks brands might come to you and then they say, oh, we want you to promote our new socks. In the long term, it's actually helping South Africa's economy grow from international brands, international companies. But I mean, it wouldn't be possible for no one to talk about socks. You know, if there was no one to talk about grass, to talk about braids, or that's the thing. What I'm saying is we need to encourage them to, you know, explore their interests on social media. Because you never know what people are interested in. People could be interested, there's interest in everything. So now what I really want to talk about is that I think we need to move away from forcing kids to become lawyers, to become accountants, to become doctors, like if they don't want to, because at the end of the day, you know, they're gonna go to varsity, they're gonna study for how many years, 3 years, 4 years, 7 years, accumulate all this debt from these 3 years, 7 years of study, and then it turns out that there's no job. First of all, right, I'm not saying that we shouldn't be pursuing becoming doctors, becoming lawyers. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is I think we should first explore social media and how to bring in money into South Africa through influencing. So maybe the 3 years of their school, like being in high school and learning how to become an influencer, learning how to be building a community, things like that from high school, right? Then they making money, making revenue, and then maybe they can take like a year after matric to make, to gain more money, acquire more money from influencing. And then if they feel like, okay, I want to actually become a lawyer, then they can use that money to pay for their schooling instead of accumulating debt. Becoming a lawyer, before you can make that money, you have to pay money to acquire that knowledge. Whereas you can become an influencer for a year, make some money, and then go to varsity and then pay for your debt and pay for things like that. And what I also feel like is that kids are not some, you know, not all kids are good at memorizing, and that's what school is: answering questions, writing exams, learning how to write exams, things like that. That's like, so it's things that were needed back in 1970. You know, schools are teaching us how to do things that or teaching us skills that were required in 1970, whereas it's 2022 now. Social media is booming and it's only going to be growing. No one's working at factories, there's machines for that. We can add social media to their knowledge and give them that option to explore it, whereas now we're teaching kids how to write a letter. Who writes letters anymore? I mean, it's okay if the kid wants to be like a blogger or write articles, things like that, then they are benefiting. But I mean, not everyone wants to become a writer. Not everyone wants to become an accountant. Not everyone wants to, I don't know, become a mathematician, things like that. So I just think that to learn about social media, it's giving them more options to make money and more options to grow the economy, because that's what we're struggling with in South Africa. The economy is not growing and people are not able to get jobs. A further reason why I feel like we should be mass producing influencers is that, would you rather like have your kid be unemployed, or would you rather have your kid be an influencer in making money, talking about socks, talking about lotion, talking about whatever they want to talk about? Like, would you rather have a 21-year-old or a 23-year-old in your home, unemployed, doing nothing, trying to look for a job, but they can't find a job because jobs are scarce in South Africa, as we know. Also with the pandemic, it's very scary. But I'm just saying that, would you rather have a 25-year-old on your couch doing nothing instead of helping them become an influencer, giving them Wi-Fi to post, you know, encouraging them instead of stressing them out about, you know, finding a job? Stress them out about, you know, do something, post something, maybe build a community that will then encourage brands to invest in you, because that's what happens, right, with influencers. Brands invest in your community to post their brand, post their product, and then hopefully then they'll get sales from it. There's a lot of poverty in South Africa, as we know, and some kids can't afford to go to varsity. Your mom can afford to buy your phone. Why don't we encourage them to post on that phone, to make videos, to make YouTube videos, to just post pictures of themselves? But that's the thing, like, we look down upon social media as if it's a fad, like, but so it's happening. Social media is gonna be here forever, and we need to really utilize it, because at this point right now, social media is not even at its peak. So now, what if we are at the forefront of it, you know? What if we are there at the starting point, and then it peaks, and then we have all these influencers that are now international influencers, basically famous, basically celebrities? So I feel like we need to be pushing more towards mass producing influencers, especially starting from grade 8, because I mean, everyone in grade 8, probably not everyone obviously, but most kids in from grade 8 to grade 12 have phones. Basically, they have a phone, and most of them want to become influencers. Why don't we, instead of telling them that they're useless, instead of telling them that, you know, you're not good at maths, you're not good at English, rather tell them, oh, maybe you should try painting, maybe you should try talking about your life on YouTube, maybe you should try posting a picture of your new sneakers, maybe, do you know what I'm saying? Things like that can really evolve South Africa into, you know, something different, really evolve us and grow our economy. But we look down on social media. I don't know why. Everything is based off community. You know, business is created of community. You can't tell me that ShopRite just randomly decided, oh, we want to open up ShopRite. No, there was a community that liked the prices, the location of the brand, and from there it was word of mouth, and that's how they grew. Last point, what I am trying to say in this whole entire video is that we need to move away from pushing kids to go to varsity. We need to encourage them more to become influencers. And I believe in that wholeheartedly. Like, I believe that South Africa needs to be mass producing influencers. Not mass producing unemployed degree holders. That's what's happening. We are mass producing unemployed degree holders instead of mass producing influencers. That's what we should be doing. That's the easiest way for them to make more money, influencing and being on an international platform. Providing them with the tools to be on international platforms is the only way that we are going to grow the South African economy. But we can't do that if our parents, if government looked down on social media and putting too much pressure on kids to be good at school. Not everyone knows how to memorize work. Not everyone wants to read. Not everyone wants to do mathematical calculations. Sometimes some people just want to take a picture, post. What is wrong with that? People make 10,000 rand a month from just posting a picture, from just posting a video on YouTube. Why don't we encourage that more instead of suffocating their dreams and forcing them into mass amounts of debt? But yeah, that's it for my video. I just wanted to put that out there, encourage people to really pursue social media as a career, actually, as a career option or as a means to make money. But yeah, thank you for watching. I hope you like, subscribe, I guess, to my video. Yeah.